In this video, we'll be taking a look at three MLB games happening on September 11, 2022. Welcome back to Cash Out Sports. Let's dive right into it. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe and to click the bell icon to get notified as soon as these videos get released so that you have more time to plan out your bets as we provide these videos on a daily basis. I can guarantee that you'll have all the important information that you'll need on these three MLB games after fully watching this video. One more thing before we start, if you would like to gain access to our best exclusive betting picks to take your sports betting journey to the next level, then check out our Patreon in the link down below where we offer anywhere from one betting pick a day up to 10 betting picks a day and much more. Now let's get started. Toronto Blue Jays versus Texas Rangers. This Sunday, the Toronto Blue Jays and the Texas Rangers will play the final game of this three-game series. The first pitch will be thrown out inside Globe Life Field. The last time that these two teams matched up, the Blue Jays ended up taking two of three games. The Toronto Blue Jays are coming into this one after taking down the Baltimore Orioles in their last four-game series. The Blue Jays looked great at the plate, as they were consistently reaching base safely and driving in men when they were in scoring position. The Texas Rangers are entering this game after losing their previous series to the Houston Astros. The Rangers struggled at the plate, as they were shut out in Game 1. They will need to wake up at the plate if they want to challenge the Blue Jays at home. Toronto has played very well down the stretch and has moved into the second wild card position in the American League. Toronto is 5 games up on the Orioles, who are the first team out of the playoffs. Toronto is starting Trevor Richards, who will only last a couple of innings. In his last outing, Richards gave up 3 runs over 0.2 innings for the Jays. For Texas, Martin Perez has allowed 6 runs over his last 18 innings pitched. Martin Perez has been pretty solid this season, but will face a very good Blue Jays lineup. Perez is 0-2 in his last 2 games, and he gave up 5 earned on 9 hits and 4 walks in 5 innings back on August 31st. That said, Perez bounced back well in his last outing with 1 earned on 6 hits and a walk in 7 innings during a tough luck defeat. If he can put together another outing like that, I think Perez and the Rangers will be in good shape. So the Texas Rangers money line is our full game side pick. Perez looked great in his last few starts, as he pitched for 7 innings against the Astros the last time he was on the mound. He also held them to 1 earned run, as he was dealing in that one. I see him carrying that momentum over into this game, as the Blue Jays team total will remain low throughout this game. Now, I also see the Rangers struggling at the plate in this one, as they are 1-9 in their last 10 games. They have continued to struggle to score enough runs to challenge their opponents, as they have continued to strand base runners in scoring position. The Blue Jays bullpen will be able to keep them off the scoreboard for the majority of this game, as Texas will continue to struggle in this one. This is going to be a low-scoring battle, as I don't see either of these teams exploding at the plate. I'm expecting a low-scoring battle in this one, as Martin Perez is going to be able to keep the Blue Jays off the scoreboard for the majority of the game, as he has been on a roll as of late. Under the projected total is our full game total pick. Chicago White Sox versus Oakland Athletics. The Chicago White Sox face the Oakland A's in the final game of the four-game set, with both teams heading in opposite directions to wrap up the season. The White Sox have a 72-68 record and, with a four-game winning streak, remain right on the heels of the Cleveland Guardians for first place in the American League Central Division. The A's, meanwhile, have a 50-90 and have lost their last 5 games, putting them in last place in their division and the American League. For the final game of the series, the White Sox will turn to Johnny Cueto as their starting pitcher, who has only allowed 2 runs in his last 2 starts, while the A's will turn to Cole Irvin to start the game. Chicago is 8-2 in their last 10 games overall and 4-1 in their last 5 road games, while the over is 5-0 in their last 5 Game 4 matchups. Oakland is 9-23 in their last 32 games overall and 18-45 in their last 63 home games, while the over is 3-0-1 in their last 4 games against a team with a winning record. The A's are looking to end the series on a high note and avoid the sweep at home. The problem is that the White Sox are playing remarkable baseball across the board and once again look to overwhelm the A's from the first inning. The White Sox, who average 4.32 runs per game, should drive in runs at will, with Jose Abreu, Andrew Vaughn, and the rest of the lineup making hard contact and powering the ball against Cole Irvin and the rest of the A's pitchers to easily play base runners. The White Sox should also limit an awful A's lineup, with Johnny Cueto building off of 2 starts where he's only allowed 2 runs and pitching multiple scoreless innings to allow the bullpen to comfortably close out the game. The White Sox need to keep winning with the Guardians owning their weekend series against the Twins, and Chicago's just been the better team over the course of this series as it is. I believe that the White Sox rally behind Cueto and get another big road game here, so the Chicago White Sox money line is our full game side pick. The total is set inexplicably low here at 7.5 runs. That's probably due to the fact that the A's are such a bad offensive team, but they are a bad pitching team too, and their starter Irvin has been getting pummeled as of late. The over is 5-0 in the White Sox last 5 games during game 4 of a series and 3-0-2 in their last 5 games versus a team with a winning percentage below .400. Also, the over is 3-0-1 in the Athletics last 4 games versus a team with a winning record. The A's lineup has been awful this season, but the White Sox have been carried by their batting order and both lineups look to step up and drive in runs against 2 struggling starting pitchers. The A's should play base runners with Seth Brown, Sean Murphy, and the rest of the lineup making contact and putting together strong plate appearances against Johnny Cueto. The White Sox, who have scored 38 runs in their last 4 games, should run up the score with Jose Abreu, Andrew Vaughn, Lewis Robert, and the rest of the lineup swinging for the fences and powering the ball at will against the A's pitchers to circle the bases throughout the game. I like the White Sox to score 7 runs on their own against Irvin and the Oakland bullpen, and the A's will scratch out a couple of runs to push this past the total. This will be a high-scoring game with both lineups stepping up. Over the projected total is our full game total pick. Arizona Diamondbacks versus Colorado Rockies. The Colorado Rockies will host the Arizona Diamondbacks in the finale of a 3-game series Sunday. The Rockies will be going for the sweep after beating the Diamondbacks 13-10 on Friday and 4-1 on Saturday. The Diamondbacks are 4-1 in their last 5 Sunday games and 39-91 in their last 130 road games. The Rockies are 2-7 in their last 9 Sunday games and 1-6 in their last 7 during game 3 of a series. The over is 13-5 in Diamondbacks last 18 overall. The over is 4-1-1 in Rockies last 6 overall. The Diamondbacks are 4-11 in the last 15 meetings in Colorado. The Diamondbacks have won 4 of their last 7 games and 4 of their last 6 road games. They've been playing well offensively during the stretch, scoring 5 or more runs in 4 of their last 5 games. They won't have trouble scoring against the Rockies because Feltner has struggled on the mound, giving up 17 runs in his last 5 starts. He gave up 5 runs in his last start against the Diamondbacks and will have a hard time slowing them down. The Rockies have won 3 of their last 5 games and 5 of their last 8 home games. Even though they are playing well offensively, they will have a hard time scoring against the Diamondbacks because Gallen has been dominant on the mound, going 6 straight starts without giving up a run, while going at least 7 innings in 5 of those starts. He didn't give up a run in his last start against the Rockies and will keep their offense in check. The Arizona Diamondbacks aren't a team you should be thrilled to lay big juice with, especially in their current form, but there's no doubt they have the pitching edge here. Ryan Feltner has had serious issues this season, while Zach Gallen is posting a 2.42 earned run average and 0.92 WHIP. Gallen has even had success against the Rockies, holding current hitters to a .221 batting average in 140 at-bats. So the Arizona Diamondbacks money line is our full game side pick. The total here is too high for a game that Zach Gallen is starting. Even though Coors Field is a hitter park, Gallen has excelled there in his career against the Rockies. The Diamondbacks have also only allowed more than 3 runs in 1 of Gallen's last 9 starts, and for Arizona to put up 9 runs alone is a stretch. Under the projected total is our full game total pick. That's all for now, so if you have any other games you would like reviewed, then leave a comment down below with the game you would like analyzed. Subscribe to our channel, leave a like on this video, and we'll get to it as soon as we possibly can. We would also love to hear your opinion on the picks presented to you in this video, whether you agree or disagree with them, so leave a comment down below and do let us know.